Welcome to the lecture series on Renewable Energy Engineering. I am Neeli Trivedi, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Let us start with our first chapter, Scenario of Renewable Energy Sources. In this, we will study about the renewable energy sources and conventional energy reserves. So, let us study about Scenario of Renewable Energy Sources. This chapter will contain the first one, man and energy, second one, classification of energy resources, third, world's production and reserves of energy, fourth, India's production and reserves of energy, and fifth, need of renewable energy. Now, let us understand the man and energy first. The body uses the food we eat. Eat to provide energy, to build and repair tissues, and to regulate metabolism. If these three functions, the human body ranks every production first and will use the food for this purpose at the expense of the other two functions in time of the need. Hence, energy is the essence of life. We require the energy. Okay? Now, as a definition of energy, energy is the capacity to do work. And what is the definition of work? Work is a form of energy called mechanical energy, we can say. Now, how we can consider what is the energy and what is the work? Like, when we throw a ball and run a mile, we have to do work. We have to produce mechanical energy. For a long ago, we found origin of fire as a source of heat and light. This is also a form of energy. And till now, it becomes the essence of life. Without the fire, heat and light, we cannot survive. By the time we found the other source of energy as electricity, the era changed like never before. Now, non-renewable energy. The source of energy are renewable and non-renewable. In the non-renewable energy, we can see the coal, petroleum, natural gas, and nuclear energy. Coal is used in the world by 4 to 5 centuries, and petroleum we are using nearly by 1 to 2 centuries. Okay, so now let us understand what is coal and what is petroleum, natural gas, and nuclear. Now, first of all, coal is the natural reserve and is a hard rock, which can be burned as a solid fossil fuel, and it is mostly the carbon but also contain hydrogen, sulfur, oxygen and nitrogen. It is a sedimentary rock formed from peat by the presence of rock laid down later on the top. Coal can be burned for the energy or the heat. About 2/3 of the coal mined today is burned in the power stations to make electricity, as you see in this diagram. Like oil, when coal is burned, the hydrocarbon joins the oxygen in the air and make a lot of pollution. From the coal, countries are turning to the new sources of energy, such as solar power. But now, coal power plants are still being built in some part of the world, such as China. When burnt, give us the almost the third more carbon dioxide per unit of the energy than oil, and 80% is more than the natural gas. Almost half of the carbon dioxide from the people is because of the burning of the coal. So it is the biggest single cause of global warming. Coal industries, and it contributes to the acid rain and smoke, especially when burned without the scrub. So here, let us understand what the petroleum is. Petroleum is naturally occurring liquid found beneath the earth's surface and can be refined into the fuel. As you know, from this petroleum we will get diesel, petrol, gasoline, petroleum jelly, etc. Petroleum is a fossil fuel, meaning that it has been created by the decomposition of organic matter over the millions of years. Petroleum is formed when large quantities of dead organisms, primarily zooplankton and algae, underneath the sedimentary rock are subjected to intense heat and pressure. Petroleum used as fuel to power vehicle, heating units and machines, as well as being converted into plastic and other materials, because the majority of the world relies on the petroleum for many good reserves and good services. The petroleum industry is extremely powerful and a major influence on the world politics and as the global economy. Now, let us classify the energy resource. Basically, it is having the four types. First one is according to the usability of energy. It is having three main types: primary resources, intermediate resources and secondary resources. Second one is of according to the traditional use. So it will contain conventional as well as non-conventional energy resources. Third one is according to the long-term availability. It will have the non-renewable resources and renewable resources. And the fourth one is according to the commercial application. So it is having commercial energy and non-commercial energy. Now, let us study about the coal reserves in the world, in India, as well as in India. As you see the diagram, there are two diagrams. One is for the world, another one is for the India, the reserves of the coal. First one, which will give us the world coal reserves, in 2018 stood at 1055 billion tons and are heavily concentrated in just a few countries. In US, it is 24%. In Russia, it is 15%. In Australia, it is 14%. And in China, it is 13%. Most of the reserves are anthracite and bituminous coal, nearly 70% of its reserves. Now, if we see the India has the fifth and largest coal reserve in the world. As on 31st March 2018, students, it is the newly won added data. So, as on 31st March 2018, India has 319.04 billion metric ton. It means 351.68 billion short tons of the resources. The non-reserve of the coal rose 1.23% over the previous years, with the discovery of the estimated 3.88 billion metric ton, which is 4.28 billion short ton. It means we are having the wonderful reserve of the coal all over the world. Now let us start with the oil reserves. Now here there are also two diagrams. One will contain the world one and the second is containing the India one. Now, top 5 countries with the largest coal oil reserves as Venezuela, Saudi Arabia, Canada, Iran, Iraq, Russia, Kuwait, United Arab Emirates. Now, if you see the values in the Venezuela, it is 304 billion barrels. In Saudi Arabia, it is 298 billion barrels. In Canada, it is 170 billion barrels. In Iran, 156 billion barrels. In Iraq, 145 billion barrels. In Russia, 107 billion barrels. In Kuwait, it is 102 billion barrels. And in United Arab Emirates, it is 98 billion barrels. Now, as you know, regarding our requirement of oil reserves, so the government of India planning to take the oil with the Iraq region. Okay. Now you have studied in your previous lectures. Now let us start with the India. What India holds? Now India holds 4.72 billion barrels of proven oil reserves of 2016, ranking 24th in the world and accounting for about 0.3% of world's total oil reserves. Okay. Now, India has proven reserves equivalent to 2.9 times as its annual consumption. As we all know, we require more as compared to how much we produce in the oil reserves. Now, let us start with the natural gas reserves. Now, here there are again two comparisons. One is of the world and another one is for India. Now, let us have the top 5 countries having the biggest natural reserves. First one is Russia, second is Iran, third is Qatar, then Turkmenistan and then United States. Now, if we see the Russia, it is having 38 trillion cubic meters, in Iran 32 trillion cubic meters, in Qatar 24.7 trillion cubic meters. In Turkmenistan, it is 19.5 trillion cubic meter, and in United States, it is 12.9 trillion cubic meters. And if we go through the recent studies of the gas reserves in India, India holds 43 trillion cubic feet of proven gas reserves as of 2017. Ranking 22nd in the world and accounting for about 1% of world's total natural gas reserves, which is 6,923 trillion cubic feet. India has proven reserves equivalent to 22.1 times in its annual consumption. Now, let us study about hydroelectric power. So, as you see, there are two diagrams, one is for world, another one for India. So, the hydropower, which is the most important and widely used renewable source of energy, hydropower represents about 17% of international energy agencies of total electricity production. So, you can understand that how much it is large in the value. China is the largest producer of hydroelectricity, followed by the Canada, Brazil and United States. Remaining countries produces very less amount of hydro energy. We can check in the Indian nationals. Now let us start. In India, it is the fifth globally installed hydroelectric power capacity. As of the 31st March 2020, it means it is the latest one value. India is installed utility scale hydroelectric capacity was about 46,000 megawatt in or 12.3% of the total utility power generation capacity. In addition to the smaller hydroelectric power units with a total capacity of 4,683 megawatt or nearly 1.3% of its total utility power generation capacity, has been installed in India's hydroelectric power potential is estimated as 148.7 watt at 60% of load factor. The financial year 2019 and 20, the total hydroelectric power generated in India was 156 ton watt hour, excluding the small hydro, with an average capacity factor of 38.71%. Now, let us start nuclear power generation value. Now, as you see, the nuclear power is very much generated in the world as well as in India. So, there are two graphs. One is for the world, another for the India. Around 10% of world's electricity is generated by about 440 nuclear power reactors. As you see, it's about 50 more reactors are under construction, equivalent to the approximately 15% of estimating capacity. In 2019, nuclear plants supplied 2657 ton of ton watt hour of electricity, up from 2563 ton watt hour in 2018. It means we are producing larger electricity with the nuclear power plants rather than our previous years. Over 50 countries are using nuclear energy as about 220 research reactors. In addition to the research reactors, these reactors are used for the production of medical industries and isotopes as well as for trading. As of March 18, India has 22 nuclear reactors in operation in 7 nuclear power plants with the total installed capacity of 6,780 MW. Nuclear power produced the total of 35 ton watt hour and supplied 3.22% of Indian electricity. So India is also dependent upon the nuclear power reactors. Now, more nearly in 2017.7 more reactors are under the construction with the combined generation capacity of 4300 megawatt. In the graph, there are places in which nuclear power plants are established. Now, let us consider our non-conventional energy sources in the world as well as in the India. In the last two centuries, Ireland and Norway generates all their electricity based on renewable energy already. And many other countries have then set a goal to reach up to 100% of renewable energy in the future. At least 47 nations around the world are ready to have 50% of electricity from renewable energy sources. While the renewable energy projects are on the large scale, renewable technologies are also studied in the rural as well as remote areas and developing countries where energy is of the crucial in the human development. India was first country in the world to set up a Ministry of Non-Conventional Energy Resources. Ministry of Non-Conventional Energy, in short known as MNRE, in the early 1980s. And it is the public sector undertaking. The Solar Energy Corporation of India is responsible for the development of solar energy industry in India. Hydroelectricity is administered separated by Minister of Power and not included in MNRE. So in MNRE, we are only considering the solar energy. Now, production of electricity. So here is a chart based on the production of electricity with the renewable as well as non-renewable energy. India now generates around 1,160.1 billion units of electricity in the financial year 2017, up 4.72% from the previous year. India's electricity sector is dominated by fossil fuels, particularly coal, which is during the 2018 and 19 financial year produced about 3/4 of the country's electricity. So the government is making effort to increase investment in renewable energy. Why they are making the effort? Because we are having the coal reserves and we are using the coal reserves as by using the coal reserves we are using the electricity production. And it is not very good for the world. It is expected that non-fossil fuels generation and giving the contribution is likely to around 44.7% of total gross electricity generation by the year 2029 and 30. So now, what is the need of energy? First of all, generating energy that produces no greenhouse emission from fossil fuels and reduces some type of air pollution. Diversifying energy supplied and reducing dependence on imported fuels. Creating economic development, jobs in manufacturing, installation and more. More of our electricity comes from the coal, nuclear and other non-renewable power plants. Producing energy from the resources takes a severe toll on our environment, polluting our air, land and water. Renewable energy is the energy derived from natural resources that replenish themselves over the period of time without polluting our earth resources. These resources also have the benefit of being abundant, available and in some capacity nearly everywhere, and they cause little if any environment damage. Energy from the sun, wind, thermal energy stored in the earth crust are as the examples. Energy diversification encourages economic growth. Drawing energy from the multiple sources and supplies insulates our day-to-day consumption, and it supports the nation from energy disruption when one source of supply is unable or unwilling to cope up or to meet with the demand. Energy diversification ensures continued energy security. Developing renewable energy resources such as solar, wind power diminishes the threat of energy scarcity. Renewable resources emit the little or no pollution and have minimal impact on the environment. Investment in renewable energy also spur innovation and job growth. So student, this is the study on scenario of renewable energy sources. This chapter will contain only 2% of total of your marks weightage in GTU, but this will contain approximately 100% in the earth area. The detailed study will give the exact information of current energy uses and generation. Thank you all of you for watching this video. If you have any query, you can contact me. Thank you.